The first improv story of the night is guy gets barred from a pub. Let the story commence. There was a guy, and this guy's called Craig. He's walking into his local pub. He goes to Monday, Wednesday, Friday and Saturday, and he goes on a Sunday for a pub lunch with his family. So he's in the Monday, fine. And then the Wednesday, fine, no problems. And then the Friday, fine. And then the Saturday, he can't remember. He can't remember, to be honest with you. Anyway, it's the Sunday, and getting the family together. Come on, come on, come on, hurry up. Got to go to the pub for a pub lunch. And his wife, who's called Mary, is saying, you were there last night? Were you there last night? Yep. Mm-hmm, I was there. Is that where, the state you came in last night, is that where you were before you came in? Or did you just start off there at the pub and then go somewhere else and get even more drunk?
I was drunk.
I wasn't drunk, was I? Was I that drunk? Pretty bad. No, I was thinking I was there all night. But you're pretty drunk.
That's fine.
But did you get up to anything? I can't remember. I can't remember. Maybe I had one or two too many, I don't know. So, anyway, come on, come together, children, come on. Mary, come on, come on, get in the car, come on, kids. And they all get in the motor and they drive to the pub. He's local, he's regular. They walk in at the pub, he goes in first. And then he doubles back. Before the rest of them come in, he's like, perhaps we should go somewhere else. It's a bit busy in there. Come on, we'll not go in there. Go somewhere else.
But Dad, I love it in there.
No. We're going to go somewhere else. It's a bit busy. There's a football match on.
Oh, a football match. I love football, Daddy.
Just not. Craig, can we go in, please? I don't want to go somewhere else. Me and the kids are hungry, says Mary. I don't think it. Come on, kids. They push by. They go to push by him, but there's not enough room, so they end up pushing him in. He's like, wait, hold on. No, what is it? What's going on here? She ends up pushing him in. She's ready to push him right in the door. And he's like, no, stop. She's like, what's going on, Craig? What's all this about? You've been keeping secrets from me, yeah? And Craig says, do I know the truth? Yeah, I wouldn't mind. The truth wouldn't. Hearing the truth right now wouldn't be amiss. It wouldn't go unappreciated. Let's just say that, Craig. I got barred. You got barred? My God. What did you do to get... Craig! What did you do to get barred? I'll tell you in the water. No, come on, I want to speak to them. I go barred. Don't push it, because if you push it, they're not going to ever let me back in. I'm maybe just barred for a week or something, right? I'm barred. What did you do? What were you doing? Were you hassling people? I'm going to have a word with them. No, don't. She barges by. She barges by to have a word with this landlord. The amount of money she's not speaking to him yet, but she's thinking, I'm going to give the landlord a piece of my mind. Not only does he come here 1, 2, 3, 4 nights a week, Monday, Wednesday, Friday, and this Saturday himself with his pals, but we come here every Sunday. We have been coming here for 5 years. Ready to go and have a word. She goes in. And there's the truth. Fucking bodies lying everywhere, man. Bodies lying everywhere, man. Cunts with their faces ripped straight over like that. Like a fucking Joker. Like a Joker, like that. Cunts lying there. Landlord's lying there, dead man, fucking throat rip, mouth's all right, somebody with a fucking pint glass smash right in the fucking eye like that. It's fucking Wayne's in there, man. Wayne's lying dead man. Fucking Wayne's lying there, dead man. He killed the fucking Wayne's and everything, man. Killed them all. Mary's like, did you do this? Craig, did you do this?
Thank you.
I can't remember, but it's coming back to me now. Fucking lying everywhere. These pals are lying there. Fucking throat's ripped. Did the dog survive, says Heavy Bob. You know, this is the sort of pub you can take dogs in. Fucking dogs are lying there. Mutilated. The dogs are mutilated, man. Craig's dead embarrassed because the Waynes have came in his Waynes. And they're like, oh my god. Daddy. It's not real, is it? It's not real. His Waynes are like, it's not real, is it? His Waynes fucking 8 and 5. It's not real, is it? Daddy. Body's lying everywhere, it's humming, man, because you know how shite comes out your body when you're dead. Plus, he's fucking ripped him open. The wee Wayne, his youngest wee 5 year old boy. Daddy, what did you do to the dog? Craig cut the dog into pieces. He cut the dog off of the hips down and he planted the arse onto this guy's nose, and so that he can see that the nose is up the dog's arse, he's cut off the tail. And see the upper body of the dog. But the dog's cut off of the neck. Just the upper body, you know, like the kind of chest, that there. And he's off. Craig's taken that. And he's put that. Like, he's chopped the landlady. The landlady is this wee stocky woman, wears a kind of tartan sort of skirt hanging. Now, what do you call it? Dog tooth, funnily enough, right? But that's what it is. Dog tooth, the zigzaggy looking thing. For the waist down, and he's taken the body of the dog and shoved it inside her hips, kind of plugged it inside like a cork in a bottle. If you can't visualise it, you'd have to be there. But they heated the dog. That's lying on the fucking record player. They've got an old record player jukebox in there. They've had it since day one. Fucking dog's heat's gone around. What? The wind's like, Daddy, it's not real, is it? And he's looking at these fucking wains. He's looking at his fucking son, man. He's looking at his daughter. And he's looking at his wife. And he's like, there's no way out of this, man. There's no way out of this. He's going to be in counselling for the rest of his life. She's going to be in counselling for the rest of their life. And she's going to be fucking, I don't know. I'm finished with her. Cuts him up with ribbons, man. Chops him up. He chops him up, man. He feels bad about it. He's not all bad. He's not completely evil. He feels bad about it. He chops him up. And, he starts laughing, man. Just starts laughing, man. He starts laughing because there's nothing else you can do. And I know. Am I right, Trips? Am I right? There's nothing else you can do but laugh, man. Am I right? I'm no wrong. All you can do is laugh, do you know what I mean? The end.